Now I'll build TCL. So change into the Unix directory and configure from there. Build package. And install, make some private headers and a symbolic link. So expect next. We've got a patch. Another little patch and configure. Build it and install. Deja GNU. Oops, now that's force of habit. So just configuration and an installation command here. And now we can move on to build GCC for the second time. Okay, so first we check that the expect is working, or the PTI is working rather, and that's the correct output. And we do some fixes. We don't need to do that change to GCC this time. It's unnecessary. So everything else we do now just follows the manual. So the above patch is critical. We've done that. Let's create the build directory. Configure the build. And this takes about 10 minutes, this part. Okay, so that's completed building. I'm going to go to the chapter 6 for GCC because there's more information there again about running the tests and viewing the results. Just got to remember to go back to chapter 5 after I've done this. So again, I'll time this. I think this takes about 50 minutes, an hour or so. So once that's done, we'll come back and check the results. Right, so that's finished after 49 minutes. Let's get some results and put this through this as well. Okay, fit on the page anyway. So expected passes 12,408. Unexpected successes, expected failures, unsupported tests, so that's okay. Expected passes, failures, untested, unsupported, number of expected passes. So again, exactly how exactly the same results as I got when I was testing this. There's no unexpected fails, so that does look all good. So we can do make install now. And once again, do this test to make sure that the correct dynamic library is being used. And that's GCC done. Or GCC pass 2 of the temporary section.